love the eyes.
Hi.
I'm Jason.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, I'm Jennifer.
Lovely
to meet you. You too.
We met as teachers about 15 years ago. We felt a friendship that we grew for a few years before it became love.
And it's been pretty fantastic.
We have an 11-year-old son named Jax.
The house that we're in, when we came to see it, it fit us then. I don't think that we would say the same thing about this house now.
Show me around.
Here we have the room in which everything happens. This is where all the stuff that is trying to leave the house lands first.
This is outgoing?
This is outgoing.
Yes.
That's a lot of stuff to need to go out.
We go back and forth with the value of a yard sale.
I'd rather get rid of all this stuff. It's not gonna make enough money that the effort is not worth enough to me.
You mean just take it to a dump?
That would be fine for me.
Like, oh, come on, you would not dump the stuff since
some of that stuff I would dump. But
This is gonna be good. I'm looking forward to this. So it's so good because, you know, I love couples who are completely on the same page. That's something we need to work on.
Yes,
all right.
For sure.
Everything that we would move in here always comes back to this wall. Are we keeping this wall? What do we do with this wall? What would you put on this wall? What if we didn't have this wall? It changes what couch we would buy for this room. It changes what television we would buy for this room. It changes what else we would keep in the room.
I can see you've got a great vinyl collection.
Yes. And then we have this behemoth television.
The television is massive.
It definitely dominates this room. The intention was for it to make it to downstairs, but it landed here.
And we don't watch enough television that needs to be a central focal point in this greeting space.
All underneath the television are games, and we keep all of the game collection up here just because we have a fantastic kid, and we would love to play games more than watch television. We're really lucky our kid still thinks we're cool.
No, they still do at 12.
Yes. Yeah.
This is our kitchen.
Well, there's a lot going on in here.
My favorite color is orange. We gravitate to stronger, brighter colors.
I think we are pretty uninhibited.
And we'd like our home to reflect that.
I have to say, I'm a fan of lots of color. I am a fan of orange. I'm not a fan of too much color or too much orange. This falls into the latter.
So, like, this space here, this is really the kitchen.
That's the working kitchen.
Even when we're cooking, we all cook together. There's not room for somebody to be over here, someone to be in the corner over here. So they end up taking things to the table or to the bar top.
The average kitchen is not designed for three people in a relatively small home. So we'll talk about how to change this up within the limitations of what we have here. The lack of space and your $90,000 budget.
This is our downstairs room.
Who plays the drums?
Nobody really. This makes it easier if I have my bandmates come over. They don't have to bring the drums. We already have something set up.
This is just for hanging out, a tiny TV, and another monitor over there.
So Jason predominantly works from home. So our house kind of flows with where he works. He sits down here for work sometimes. He sits in the first level sometimes. He uses the bedroom sometimes.
What do you need for work?
I don't need much. Usually my laptop is sufficient.
Right, so. Okay. Stuff has to give a little bit.
Right. He's super accommodating. So
probably to a fault.
Look, I'm here not because I want to make your house look nicer. That's a byproduct of why I'm here. I'm here to create harmony and function within your home because you clearly do not have that. You shouldn't be super accommodating to a fault. You shouldn't be super accommodating to a fault. We have to try and find our meeting ground, and that will be a give and a take. It's about emotionally being connected and happy with each other and with your kid and with this house.
So we spent a lot of time in Cara Green. We made choices. It was done. Everyone was happy. We have a plan. I leave. And then I hear Jennifer has gone into the cabinet makers, spoken to Jamie, and told us she wants a different color.
Just wanted to see, what does the color that we've agreed to for cabinets look like on full scale? I'm a visual learner, a visual teacher, and she was showing me what we had agreed to, and out of the corner of my eye, I saw something with a little more color, and I asked, how can we get that? So we got some extra color.
I don't know why she thinks she needs to go behind my back and make different choices. I'm on her side. I want to make this work. I also want to give her and Jason the benefit of my experience.
Hey, hey.
Hi.
Need your sunglasses?
Well, it is bright, light.
It will look different, and it will look interesting, and it will look quirky. It's all going to be exactly the way Jennifer wants it.
Oh, my. Wow. I mean, it's totally transformed. This is nothing like the house that we left at all.
There's a lot to see. So we had a wall here.
Oh, I love this.
Are you feeling a gravitational pull to get to the kitchen?
Yes.
Then let's get into that. Let's talk about the countertop and the fights and the arguments and the tussles. And remember I said you can make art upon it. Sometimes this is what you need because it becomes the backdrop, the plain area to play with. You could choose whatever color you like to dress it with.
Yeah, this looks great with all the color on top of it, and it's picking up all the color that's happening in the rest of the room.
You have so much storage. Let's see. You got a pantry?
Oh, yes.
The drawers!
I wanted these. I wanted these so badly.
Loads more uppers.
Okay. So excited.
It's so much storage, and then you've got more storage beneath. I want to talk about how amazing and beautiful this is. This has created what we wanted, which is the statement when you walk into your house. This is what tells everybody who you are.
It looks absolutely spectacular.
Especially balanced on the blue.
And it goes all the way to the ceiling.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
We get color all the way up. From the first time we saw that product that said, take me home, and it looks just like we hoped for it being in the house.
Ta-da.
That is an immaculate stove right there.
Are you ready to bake?
Oh, in the oven. I didn't even notice the oven.
Wow.
That's huge. You and Jax are gonna be baking for school PTA fundraisers all the time.
Oh my goodness.
For you guys who love to cook, it was not a functioning house. It's not even that I would call it an upgrade. It's just like another planet having this in your kitchen from what you had before.
And now the straightaway to go up and down.
To move that staircase and now have an area that is usable, that has become an incredible third space for you.
I'm excited to be able to access it more easily.
Yeah.
And we can walk down there. The stairs go right down.
Do you want to go into the living room area?
I would love to.
Wow.
So much space.
So rearrange this way now because you just need the connection with the kitchen for all the reasons we talked about. If you had a huge gathering, everybody can still just, the chairs can be at angles or around. Everybody can see and hear and interact with each other. Everybody in here, you could just have a wonderful gathering. Here you have the sofa you can stretch out on. And then these lovely chairs, which swivel?
Oh, they swivel. This is fun.
Pulling the orange over to here,
this
too.
This is really...
It is nice. I like it. It's weird,
it's
but...
It's very fun.
You've got to get as much seating as you can here, so you've got seating here as well if you had a whole bunch of people. Different areas for people to talk to each other. Nice little collection of your odds and ends here, and of course your vinyl collection. We talked about some of them going downstairs.
Okay. We can rotate them through and listen to them more consistently.
Exactly. And then of course, little places that you could sneak storage. And all of the elements that we brought in here, everything pulls together.
I do see how it pulls together. Now we have that sitting area that is not TV-centric, it is not in the kitchen. We can just talk and enjoy company.
It is the realization of something that you've been struggling over, talking about, thinking about, and just not doing. We are, right now, where you really wanted to be around 9 years ago, and you just couldn't get there for so many different reasons. And now you have Jax growing up. This is going to be great for him to come here and know that he can hang out with his friends and there is actually space. It's a fully functioning home for where you are now and where you're going. So it's a whole new beginning. I love it.
Flow. That was one of the things that was most important to you.
We got the color in there. It feels like a reflection of who we are. It feels like a house for Jason and Jennifer.
And Jax.
And Jax.